I'm gonna come over and watch, but I'm not gonna ask any questions. Promise, swear, okay?
Promise, swear.
Yeah, that's like a double-sided, super-duper, no take-backsies promise. It's pretty intense.
I see that.
Like, it's accepted in the court of law, so what are you gonna do? Do we do your bracelet off?
Yeah.
I'm gonna pause this video. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna make it do. I have too many ideas right now. I need to finish commission work. So, I was gonna ask a question.
I know, but what? Why? What are you gonna ask?
I was gonna ask where you got the idea or the inspiration for your color palette.
I didn't. I just
saw
like
it?
The colors.
Someone asked on a video last night, why did you switch from Envirotex?
I know, I wanted to remember that. Like, I wanted to make sure that we addressed that and we didn't. We're just experimenting with other colors or with other resins.
We still love Envirotex. In fact, this piece is Envirotex, right? Right. The reason why we've been experimenting with other resins like the Countertop FX Epoxy and the Distinctive Concrete Concepts Epoxy is because we needed to find something more sturdy for the countertops and bar tops and tabletops that we've been doing lately. We still, for the artistic side, prefer Envirotex. It's got the best working time and it accepts thicker body pigments the best. So, you're shaking your camera. Oh, you fancy, huh?
Will you just make sure it's like focusing on...
Ugh, almost just died. Yeah, I can see from just past the table, like here, to
yeah, sometimes it'll
the end
focus
of your paper.
Right here, like...
It'll catch
something in...
Also, you guys, just so you know, any piece that you see in our videos is probably for sale. I'm gonna start linking direct to our website. If the piece is for sale, it'll be a link in the bottom. I've also started linking to the Amazon pigments and colors. I've started to link the colors to where you can get them on Amazon. I've decided to become an affiliate with them, and yeah, all that's in the description box below.
Using the old regular white. I need a timer. I don't like. I want a visual timer. I don't want a dear what's her name timer. Siri. I tried to make a orange pearl, which I could probably put more in, but I just used this FW acrylic orange with some Pearl-X real fine powder. Super purdy. I'm gonna go ahead and stick some more in there because I want it to be ultra. see. Make sure there's not a time limit on that.
I already started my timer.
Oh, on this? It's small.
There's a timer?
Like, yeah, it's timing. Okay.
And use the Mayron. Put a little bit in there. I'm gonna use some copper deco art. Extreme Sheen. Extreme Charlie Sheen. Nope, I should have shaken that up.
So Susanna.
Oh, it smells so bad.
Most of the she's starting her own pigment powder and pigment paste line called Le Rez, which sounds so fancy, and it goes well with her colors because they're super vibrant. Anyways.
Super awesome, hot, light, fast rated.
Organic violet.
No, cosmic violet.
Oh. Anyways, she's from Australia, but Laura is like being a go-between it's too many betweens. But she's the middleman for people getting it in the United States. And I want to get my hands on some of those. Because there's two pores on it before this one.
I love how that Mayron just starts popping out. And you hit that heat on it.
Much more of that blue would show through. Wow. Those look awesome. That's what I wanted to see. Those.
Just wait. When that gold separates.
like how deep that purple looks. Parts.
I think it's just gonna keep doing this.
I'm fine with that.
Man, it looks great. I'm so glad I put that. That teal at the bottom, because I feel like it would have mixed in with the orange and just got ugly.
Mm-hmm.
I guess there's no, you can't fix it, because it's just going to continue to do that.
It is, and it's not like it's a problem because it's gold and teal all the way over the edge, so I would just, you know, there's people yelling at the camera right now like, no, don't touch it. Oh my God. Take all the loose powders away from it. I think I showed you guys what happened to one of our other pieces. Yeah.
It's still awesome, I think. Just, it's like a beautiful disaster.
It is a beautiful disaster. I don't think, yeah, I posted how to do this one, but not, I don't know if I posted like, we dropped some gold, right? And then it just went. That we're just gonna put a clear coat on it and call it a beautiful disaster.
I wanted something that's kind of similar to that guy.
You know it's gonna keep moving.
I don't know, I'm trying to like layer it so it goes over itself and then it puddles up.
And then it what?
Puddles up. Mm-hmm. I right.
Let me see.
Ooh, it's moving.
We'll take another video of it after she sets up.